Hello and welcome to episode 22 of my morning coffee and sketchbook. Hey, welcome, Christy. Nice of you to join me. Good morning. So good of you to join. I'm glad I made it in time. So today I'm going to keep it super, super simple. So maybe I have a little time to talk and kind of talk about what I'm doing. So what I'm going to do today is a very basic house against, like, an old homestead against some old pine trees or some foresty looking things. So I'm just getting my shape in here. Course, we're coming from an angle, so we got to get that in there. I get so messy sometimes. I only got two people here today, so what in the world? Good morning, Nancy. We're only getting started, though, right? We're just getting started. Let's get that line just a little bit better. Get that better. Down just a little bit more that way. There we go. There's this. That's taking a little better shape. What I wanted. Drop that down there. Okay, that's kind of nice. So like I said, this is going to be so super basic. I hope you really like this one because, like I said, this is one of those ones where I'm going to be doing a lot of wet on wet. And hopefully keep all of this, or at least this area, pretty bright. So that's the goal anyway. We'll see how it turns out. This is just gonna fade right off into that. Maybe, should we put a mountain in it? We could put a little mountain up here maybe if you want. Just a little something. So we got kind of a dark, light. Yeah, that could be kind of cool. Let's do that. We'll add a mountain. So let me get this right. So we're gonna go, this is gonna be darker, this is lighter, so darker in here. Just so I don't mess this up. Then we're gonna be light, and then we're gonna add some darker values as we go down. Now if we wanted, we could do some, I don't know, maybe we could even put like a fence post in here or something. I don't know, maybe there's a fence post there and it's just going right off the screen. Who knows where it's leading to? Maybe it's just one right here. Hey, that doesn't look too bad for centered purposes, so we can go with that. Mountain, this, we're good. Okay, let's stop right there and we'll move forward. I need the basic beginner level for me. Oh, come on now. I know you got this better than you realize. I just have a feeling. So my little girl is right behind you, Phoebe. She wants to play with the big old tennis ball that I got her. She's being patient. So I think we got our sketch pretty good. It's a little rough, but it'll do exactly what I want it to do. So today I'm gonna be playing with some different, not really different, just a little different, it's in my same palette, but I want to try to create more of a summery feel. And by doing that, I'm just going to limit myself to the colors that I'm using. So I'm going to be doing a little bit of burnt sienna and cobalt. I'm going to try to stay away from ultramarine today because I want it to be a little bit more bright. So let's just see what happens with this. Let's see, let's go with the cobalt blue. Like I said before, cobalt blue. I'm just mixing my colors here. I'm going to get a little burnt sienna going too. Just a little bit. And you'll see why here in just a moment. Because what happens if you mix cobalt blue and burnt sienna? What kind of cool color do you come up with? Here we go. So dark, light, dark. So we want a fairly dark sky. I'm just mixing the color right on the page. trying to do as few strokes as possible today too. That's probably been one of the things that I've been struggling with the most, is just to get the right amount of paint strokes without making it look too overworked. Just let that do its thing right in there. So this is going to be our dark. This is going to be lighter. And what I'll probably do is I'll probably make it really dark up here and then bring it down super dark. So let's just do a quick dry so we don't have any problems with that. Yay, Bob Ross time. You are so funny. Thank you so much. And I know it's my mom's birthday today. Is she on here? I didn't see if she was on here. I gotta wish her a happy birthday for sure. Very much so. Oh gosh, you guys are too nice. So you can see that rust, or the burnt sienna and that cobalt, it makes a really pretty gray. Kind of digging that. And I'm getting these blossoms that are popping up that I really am not a big fan of, but it's really more about the paper and then letting it dry super fast. When I'm putting when you put the dryer on it, you'll get these little funky things, but that's okay. We work around them and we still make it look good. Kentucky followed the host. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. Let's see. So I said I wanted to go really dark up here, but then I'm going to lighten it down. I think for this particular one, I'm still going to go with those same colors, the blue and the burnt sienna, because I want to keep those colors way back. So cobalt blue, burnt sienna mix. And here we go. And if we wanted to leave some little highlights in there, we could, make it look like there's some little mountaintops in there or something going on. Or some snow, that's what I meant to say. Some snow peaks, maybe just a little bit of snow here and there. That's left over from the winter. And know what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna lift this up, and you'll see why in just 1 second. I'm gonna have to untape myself, so it's gonna look a little funny on screen, but just hang on and you'll see what I'm doing. There we go, now I'm just using my thumb to lift this up a little bit. Because I want those darker colors to be on the top. And now I'll add a little bit of the just plain blue down here, and as I work my way down, I'll leave some open areas on those distance. Let's just do a little bit of smoothing, should we? Just a little bit, smooth it out. Because these are still supposed to be way back. We don't want them to be too detailed. Just kind of smooth those edges. That makes kind of a nice effect, doesn't it? What do you all think? So just playing with gravity right now. This is all I'm really doing. This is all gravity. I'm just letting this kind of go in that direction to dry. My poor baby, she's back there whining because I'm not giving her any attention. Oh my goodness. All right, let's try to dry this just a little bit. Do I want to? I kind of do, but yeah, we better do it just in case. Here we go. At least the bottom line. I need to get that bottom line pretty dry. I'm gonna let it stop right there. Notice I got this kind of hard line. It almost makes it look like there's some trees in the background there, which will be even more obvious once I get to this next cool step, which is adding some, I'm gonna do the cobalt again. I think that's going to be what keeps it all together, is cobalt. The next thing I want to do is really make these pine trees super, super dark, and they're gonna come right down to the edge here. So I'm going to be adding a lot more burnt sienna. Let's see how this looks. So cobalt, heavier burnt sienna, heavier cobalt, I like that. I almost want to wet this, but I'm not going to because I'd like the edges to be soft, but we're just going to work with the different values on the inside of here to kind of make it work. So here we go. Nice sharp edge on that. There we go. This is going to be one of the darkest areas on this picture is this area right in here. So it's okay to really bump this heavy. Really kind of make it stick out. So if 43 people are still around, hey, thank you so much. Gosh, you know what? I wish I had my wife here today. She is working. Beth is working today. And I know I get a lot of people on here and I miss a lot of questions. And I know it's kind of a pain to try to get back and, you know, find the video and leave a comment or whatever. But what I'm going to do, I think, is I just kind of set up this little link tree thing that I've been playing around with. And I think I might just do somewhere where y'all can ask some questions there if I miss your comments. Let me know. Does that sound like something like I should do that? Is that a good idea? Okay, let's bump a little, just a tad bit of green, sap green in here now as we're working our way down. Ooh, that's a little bit not enough. Not nearly enough. There we go. Now let's keep that edge nice and sharp because that's going to be important. Keep that edge nice and sharp. As we work our way down, here we go, more green, coming up into here. Let's, you know, what's the opposite of green? Some red, let's put some red in here too. Get some of those grays down in here, some. Let's just tap this edge to make it pretty sharp. I like these brushes, these Raphael brushes, I really do like them. They're a synthetic. No squirrels are missing their tails. They act, from what I understand, they act like just like the others, so that's great. Like the sables and whatnot, which is pretty cool. Pop in a little bit more of that red. And the reason why I'm popping in red right here is, I'm gonna put in some more too, here and there, but I'm wanting to do an opposite. Watercolor gouache, I'm sorry, that is watercolor. Oh, thank you, Christy, for answering. Squirrels missing their tails. Oh, well, I mean, I know, I'm just joking, but still, I mean, if I can find something that works just as good as a sable and not have to, you know, I will, but I understand the squirrels aren't being harmed in the making of brushes. I get it, but, you know, that's just me being funny. Let's fix this little spot right here. That needs to be darker, darker. All the way right to there. There you go. Where is my colors going? I'm running out of colors, people. That's the bad thing. I do have, that's probably, if I'm going to admit to something that I do with watercolors is I find myself having to remix quite often. So that would probably be one of my biggest flaws when I'm doing these. Okay, I want some bright yellow. This is going to sound really funny, but just trust me on this. I'm going to do some heavy, heavy, heavy. Bright yellow right here. And there will be a reason for that in just a minute, and you will see that. It's nowhere else in the painting yet, but right here I want that little bit of yellow to be showing. Now I'm going to bring this yellow. And let's see, this is going to end up being a yellow and a cobalt. I'm going to mix it right on the paper. Let's hope this works. Ooh, isn't that bright? Didn't expect that, did you? Don't worry, I did. Smooth that right on out. A little cobalt down there. Yellow, oh yeah, look at that yellow and the cobalt mixing. That's what I'm talking about. Ooh, that's pretty. Now let's do some touches. Let's bring this up here and let it have its fun. Let the shadows happen. Very cool. Very cool. And maybe even a little darker. Yeah, that's kind of coming out all right, isn't it? Hello, Wesley. How are you doing? Sorry I missed you. I've been so focused on this. Much respect. I can play with oils for hours, but watercolor makes my brain hurt. Oh, gosh. I get it. I do. I mean, it can be a little tricky to mess with. And you see how hard that line is? That is just straight up sketch paper. I probably could have helped avoid that, but that's okay. It'll provide some interesting effects once I get back to that. Yes, I do want to go darker, actually, but I think it's time to dry. Let's get this dry. We're going to go even darker. Sorry about that. I just want to make sure this one's really good and dry because I'm going to start working with smaller brushes shortly. But first, a new color. And let's see. Here we go. A little bit of alizarin and cobalt mixed. And that was the purpose of that yellow right there, to bump, like that really stick out. Hop on back up there. And let's see here. There we go. Yeah, I don't want that. Do I want that? I could leave that, I guess. Maybe it's something hitting it back there. I want it to be fairly flat. Fairly flat. You know what? Let's just wipe that out now. And we're going to start bringing these colors up into here. Because this is going to get darker. I promise you that. It will get darker. It's the whole point of watercolors is to create light where there is no, where the white, make the white light. That's the what I'm trying to say. Somebody told me the other day, I'm no Bob Ross, and I will agree with that. I just rattle on. When the weather cools, I'm sure I'll give it a shot. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm missing so many conversations. I'm glad y'all are talking on here. That makes me happy that y'all are conversating while I'm focused. So we've got this down. And there is going to be just a little, I'm going to take this color, and I'm just going to push it right over here. And then I'm going to put a little bit right up in here. And then I'm going to make these a little darker here in just a moment. We'll just stop right there where this is. Make that a little darker in the back. So now it's starting to take shape, I hope. Thank you for following, everybody. I sure appreciate that. Next thing, let me see if I can just get this edge out of here. It's just kind of driving me nuts. Let's see, we can lighten this up a little bit. It's just that hard edge is kind of driving me bonkers. Let's just soften it up. See, that's kind of pushing everything back where it needs to be. Not so distracting back there. We're starting to get our color in here. Let's go. Oh, thank you so much. You're very talented. Looks so well. Oh, thank you, everybody. This is serendipitous. I just picked up my watercolors again yesterday. So much to learn. Oh, thank you. We're still going with this. We got a few more dark things to hit. And maybe, let's see, we're at 20 minutes into this painting is all. So I'll probably get done with it a little early. Hope y'all don't mind. We're going to start working on some of these darker colors. I always say that we're going to get there, and then I don't mix enough of them. So let's just mix. Talk to me. Well, give me some questions while I'm mixing some paint here. I'm going to start mixing my burnt sienna, cobalt, just to get it just as dark as I possibly can. There's some burnt sienna, cobalt. More cobalt. That's getting there. That is getting there. Okay, now we're starting to get a nice, dark, cold color, which is what I want. Cobalt makes pretty cold blues. And because this area is going to be so warm, I want the some of these trees in the background to really stand out as really dark shapes. So that's a bit wide. Do I got the wrong brush? I probably do. We can do this one. I like this one. This is kind of fun to play with, these old rigger brushes. Make neat little shapes. Some details in the back here, some things going on. Still keeping as true to the focus of the painting as I can. Brushes are just kind of fun to work with at times. Get some nice cool shapes out of them. Ooh, look at me. Let's see, where is it? Ay, ay, ay. Everybody's going, oh my gosh! Don't you worry. It's not the first time I've done that. That nice cold color that's they're popping in back in the back now are starting to resemble a nice little forest. And over here, I don't think we need to worry too much, so we're just gonna bring this over. Maybe make some little bumps. I want to give my little house some bushes though, so we're gonna sneak in here just to do some little bushes. There's the bushes for that side. We'll bring this and connect over here. So this guy's got a little some bushes over in here. Let's bring some more of these trees up. See how this is really puddled down here? If I just want to just use that and just flick upwards. See, I can create all sorts of neat little trees out of that. Out of this little cluster of extra water that's down there just by flicking upwards. And it should be dark down along the bottom of the forest anyway. Something like that. Okie dokie. How we doing, everybody? Nice work. Why the thumb cap? Why the thumb cap? Good question. Everybody asked me that. And honestly, I think most of my followers kind of know. I was in the military before. My fingers didn't fare too well. So I just keep that one undercover so you don't have to look at that. You can look at my pretty art instead. But I'm not embarrassed about it or anything. It's just life. That's just what happens. Okay. I think we're almost ready for some black. I'm going to do just a couple more little squiggly lines through here, I think, just to create some... I don't know, just create some visual effects. And then I want to take this, and I'm gonna run this out here like so. Because maybe there was a trail or something, I don't know. Maybe there was a trail out here that leads out to somewhere, who knows what. Okay, now for the posts. They're gonna be a little thicker, so let's get more burnt sienna, because they are going to be more brown, of course, so they should be more brown. Bring that right off like so. And when did you first get into painting? Good question. According to my mother, I was really like 2, just as soon as I was able to pick up a paintbrush or pick up something and start marking on her walls, which I don't think she was real happy with. But I did. I loved it. I never really stopped liking drawing. So I tried to make a career out of it. Ended up joining the Navy, did a career in there as well, and never stopped painting though. And now I can actually afford to paint. I know, because it's so tricky to be a, it's so hard to be an artist. I know it is, full time. So now that I'm able to do that, that's what I like to do full time and just enjoy myself. But yeah, it took me a while. So yeah, I'm just rattling on. Sorry. Sorry about that. I just thought maybe it was a grip or a dab. Oh, no. It kind of does make a nice little grip, and it's not embarrassing to me at all. So no worries. I don't mind answering questions. It's just life. And let's see, a little something up here. Maybe one over here. And then down here, maybe we'll make them a little bit bigger. It'll make seems bigger of a window. So down here, like that on this side. Now, what do you say we put in just a little? Oh, it's my pleasure. Totally is my pleasure. So, should we add a little bit of color into this thing? We've got all these cool colors. What about something nice and warm? Most of it is this bluish gray, and then we got these yellows. down in here, these yellow greens. So we could either do, to do a complimentary, we could put this as a nice red roof, which would, I mean, it should really pop. Or just an, if we bring in some of the blues, we would do an orange. So I'm thinking just an orangish reddish. Yeah, orangish reddish. And we're going to try to do this in just one or two sweeps. Rinse out the old brush. Let's see here. Get some paint on there. Come on now. That is one thing. When you go from an inexpensive brush to one of these Raphaels, they hold so much water. It's just ridiculous. So I got to really be careful what I'm doing. Okay, so we're going to put in a... How bright is this? Where's my little testing page? That's what I need. Because I don't want to get this far and then destroy it. That's good, isn't it? Maybe a little darker? Maybe just a little bit. Try this. Ooh, yeah, that's kind of pretty. Here we go. Just kind of let that fill in and do its thing. I do want to get that down nice and low on this edge though. Just pop that little bit out there. He kind of makes it look funny. There we go. And we'll lift it up to kind of even out those colors so it looks a little more smooth. Now, if I want to do something fun to really make that kind of pop, now that it is orange, I could come in here just the tiniest little bit and just kind of pop in just a little bit of blue here and there, just like so, just to give it some interest. There we go. Okay, we're about ready to go onto the super dark colors, which is almost... Watercolor and dense pencil don't mix right. Dense pencil, it can be a little tricky, but honestly, I do use pencil a lot, especially in like areas like this. I will go in and I will make, when I'm doing a sketch, I will make this area super dark with pencil. And then if I like how it turns out, I'll go over it with watercolor. It's, now obviously you gotta be careful in some of the lighter areas so you don't ruin light, but it can be done. But yeah, for the most part, if you're learning how, I would keep your pencil strokes dark enough, this is my secret, dark enough to where you see it through the entire mid-tone of the painting. Because if you lose it by the mid-tones, you're gonna get lost in the entire thing. So make sure you don't do that. All right, so now we're going straight for, I'm almost there here. I'm going to get some neutral tint. This is where I'm actually darkening up all those colors that I've been using, which is the cobalt and the raw sienna. I'm going to mix some neutral tint in there. And we're going to do just one more layer of color. Or darkness, I should say. We just want some more darkness. Because the darker you go up against the white, the brighter it's going to appear to be. Kind of crank my arm around here so I can actually paint because I don't want to move the paper. That's kind of a fun effect. I'm going to keep that. I like it. Kind of pushes it back just enough to yeah, we'll take a little bit of that out though. Just the tiniest little bit. We don't need to take much out because I kind of like that. Nice. Yep, that's kind of fun. It just kind of blent right in. I like that. Made it kind of more, become more part of the painting, kind of faded into the background a little bit. I have watercolor pencil and it seems to disappear under the, I know, that's the, that, and I'm working on one right now. It's a commission that I was working on and it was the same thing. I got quite a ways through it and I lost my lines. I actually took a picture of it and went back to try to figure out where the problems were. It was a little tricky, but I did manage to make it work. Like an old barn or farmhouse. Yeah, that's kind of what I was after. We're almost there. I'm gonna let this dry up just a little bit more, add just a couple little more details, and we'll call this one done. We're at 35 minutes into this is all. So 35 minutes isn't too bad. I think we're dry enough to where I can at least make some of these marks. Because we need, in my opinion anyway, we need just a little bit more foliage going on in here. See how much that helped, I think. A little bit of foliage going on in here. Something going on up in here. And then another thing I like doing, especially in areas like this, give me one quick second. These things are just not drying very nicely. Let's see. Let's see if I can make this work. Just brush nice and clean. I gotta make sure it's clean. If it's not clean, I'm gonna get all sorts of craziness going on here, but let's try this. The blue, so I wanna try to emphasize that bluish gray. Best way to do that is to try to add some orange somewhere into the painting. So let's just see what happens. Cool. Kind of funny you go ahead and head it up there a little bit too. That's okay. Maybe some red too. Do we want some red in there? Pop in a little bit of red color too. It's kind of fun. Okay. Last few lines. Here we go. These are the last few lines we do. Okay, I'm gonna need to be putting some white in here. I can see that as well. And here we go for this fun little part. There's gonna be something going on in here, a little something there, and then we'll do, do we need three? Probably not three. We could probably do one where it just broke. That's what we'll do. Here we go. And this one down here just kind of broke and went down. And if you want, you could do little things on them. If you want to make them barbed or something, you could just do little indications of barb if you want. It's easy to do. Let's get on to some white, should we? Thank you, Kim Ann, for becoming my top viewer. You're awesome. Thank you. And for everybody that's joined today, everybody that's followed, everybody that, oh my gosh, look at this wishing bottle. I don't even know what that is, but thank you so much. It's awesome. Thank you so much. I mean, you really have been so supportive for me on this little journey. This, like I said, this is episode 22. We do these Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. I know most of you know that already, but for those people that are new, I gotta repeat it. Okay, now we're getting into some of the white colors just to add just a little bit of here and there to make it really kind of pop. I kind of want to give it like, maybe it's got a just the slightest indication of yeah, this little roof line, there's some shutters, shingles going on, shingles, that's what I had to say. So yeah, a little something like that, just to give it just a little bit. This one's really not gonna need a lot of white, I don't think. This is, I think it's turned out all right for what it is, for a nice little sketch. It's, do I need much more white? I don't know that I do. This one is so fun. Thank you. Actually, I'm not using gouache. I grabbed the first thing that I had, and it was actually my golden acrylics. As long as you use them super light, they act like gouache. They don't get real shiny like gouache does. Good morning, Mom. Happy birthday. Everybody wish Misa Ibsen a happy birthday. She's going to hate me for that, but do it anyway. That is my mom that just popped in. Good morning. I got to call and wish you happy birthday soon. I think we're pretty good with this painting. Should we make it a little bit lively? Let's do something. I got an idea. I got a really good idea. Let's do this. I always put in dark birds, right? Let's do, if I can do this very carefully, let's do one. We'll just put him close to two. And then one way up here. He'll be flying in this way. Birdies. We've got birds. We've got it all. Time to sign, time to peel. We are at 45 minutes. Hey, we did this pretty good. It didn't take us nearly an hour. I don't know why, but watching watercolor being done teaches me far more than any book. You know what? You're absolutely right. And, you know, I've been doing this for a long time, but I am no professional. And here I am. I'm admitting I love YouTube videos. I love watching them. So don't ever think otherwise. I mean, that's how we learn these days. I mean, even our kids are learning from YouTube. All right, here goes the peel. And while I am peeling, I know I've brought this up before, but I'm going to do it really short this time. There are several ways you can support this little project that I've got going. But one of my things that I really enjoy doing is making art affordable. So I know that it can be expensive. So what I've done is I've actually put it on books, little notebooks and whatnot, so it's kind of functional art for you, and you can actually find them right on Amazon, if that ain't the coolest thing ever. Just search for Brett Wynn Art on Amazon. There's lots of notebooks, and there's an affirmation book that actually has gotten very popular, so if you're interested in that, feel free. And then, of course, I've always got my website that you can take a look at, lots of prints, Gliche prints. And oh yeah, one other thing. Heck yeah, YouTube for the win. Oh, by the way, that is another thing I got to mention. I'm moving all these downloads full length over to YouTube. However, I've been playing music for about the first 15 of them, and then everybody said, "Ah, we don't need music." So now the problem is from 15 down has music. So the only way I'm going to get those uploaded is if I just take the music completely off and add something different, but that takes away my voice. So at least for right now, episode 16 through 21 is up on YouTube if you want to watch the full versions. I'm also going to put up the little clips, little fast clips too. So with that said, everybody, I'm just so amazed. I got 54 people watching. There was 57 a second ago. Y'all are awesome. I so much appreciate your time that you spent today, and I hope you learned something. And I tell you what, you gave me a wonderful start to my morning. So I appreciate that. Thank you, everybody, and y'all have a wonderful, let me get my wonderful Wednesday. Take care now. Have a great day too. Bye now.